Hello everybody, welcome to my channel Sakshi Gopala Chemistry Classes. Dear students, आज की क्लास में हम देखेंगे अबाउट रेडियस रेशियो इन आयनिक सॉलिड. सो आवर सिनॉप्सिस इज फर्स्ट वी विल सी अबाउट आयनिक सॉलिड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द साइज ऑफ द आयंस. देन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द रेडियस रेशियो फॉर्मूला एंड फाइनली we will have a comparative tabular data presentation which depicts the radius ratio and variation with the coordination number along with the structures with examples. So let's begin our class. First of all, dear children, see, ionic solid, as we know that ionic solid is made up of ions. The ionic bond is formed by the transfer of electrons. Okay, so ionic solid have cations and anions. Usually when cations, they lost electron, and obviously their size is smaller. When we are comparing with anions, anions, due to the gain of electron, they are bigger in size. So what happens, see, anions which are bigger in size, they occupy close packed structure in lattice. Now what about the cation? Cations, they are smaller, so they occupy voids. Okay, but when we are speaking about cation which are comparably smaller, they occupy what? They occupy the tetrahedral void. Just now in our previous video class, we had learned that tetrahedral void, they are smaller than the octahedral void. Okay, so the smaller cation, they occupy tetrahedral void, and the bigger ones or the larger cation, they occupy the octahedral void. Now dear children, we know this data. The radius of tetrahedral void is 0.225 of r. Now the radius of octahedral void is 0.414 of r. So by this calculation, we came to a conclusion that tetrahedral voids, they are smaller as compared to the octahedral void. So the cations which are smaller in size, they occupy the tetrahedral void, and the cations which are bigger in size, they occupy the octahedral void. Okay, now children, what do you mean by radius ratio, and what is the importance of radius ratio? Suppose when we are talking about any ionic solid gains stability. You know, what is the factor which provide stability to ionic compounds? That factor is the maximum electrostatic force of attraction. Okay, so see, the radius ratio means radius of cation denoted by R plus divided by radius of anion denoted by R minus. Now children, we have this tabular data radius ratio. This is very, 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 very important, and in NEETS exam or in the KVS PGT chemistry exam, it is asked. So I advise you to better learn all the values along with their coordination number and the structure. So let's see one by one. This is the radius ratio. Cn is coordination number, and the structure of that particular coordination number along with the examples. So let us learn one by one. The very first one is, when the radius ratio, means radius of cation, the ratio of radius of cation to radius of anion, is under the range 0.155 to 0.225. There we have the coordination number 3 and the structure is planar, triangular, example is B2O3. Now second case, if the radius ratio is under the value 0.225 to 0.414, coordination number is 4 and the structure is tetrahedral with an example of zinc sulfide. Got it? Now the third category is 0.414 up to 0.732. Here we have the coordination number of 6. Geometry is octahedral. Example is NaCl. See, NaCl is an ionic compound with a cubic close packing, and cubic close packing is also called as face centered packing. So in this type of questions, you know, it is asked the coordination number and the geometry. Okay, so you have to remember the coordination number is 6 and the geometry is octahedral with the radius ratio in the range 0.414 up to 0.732. Now the final category, which is with us, is 0.732 up to 1. There we have coordination number 8 and structure is body-centered cubic. The example is cesium chloride. So my dear student, this NaCl and cesium chloride, both of these are very, very, very important. You mug it up. When their coordination number, see, in cesium chloride, the coordination number is A with the structure of body-centered cube and the radius ratio is 0.732 up to 1. Okay, so I hope, children, this radius ratio is clear to you. So please do like and subscribe my channel and share among all your friends. So as in this way, we can help many students who are in need to understand chemistry in a much easier language with an objective of learn to grow. Thank you on behalf of Team Sakshi Gopala Chemistry Classes. Thank you all.